In this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about lean hogs. Now, lean hogs is coming in here with a nice, beautiful little Elliott wave. And we were talking about lean hogs a couple of days ago. And we were looking for a little anticipation of a rally. And we got that nice rally. And this is what you see, this market coming in here. And again, if we come in with the bulls and bears settings of 72, which is our Elliott wave setting, standard setting for Elliott wave, we can see we got a perfect little Elliott wave coming right up in here off of this market as well. So we come in and we got our second drive in here, a little counter trend in here, and this is our third drive to the top. So there's a nice perfect little Elliott wave. We didn't get the perfect drive down, so this market still had a little bit of strength and didn't give us that second little ABC off the bottom. So we go from here, this is down to here, up to here, and we expected this market to drop a little bit further down into here going into the close of the market, but it didn't. Start to drift sideways, which is pretty typical when a market comes into the close of the business day. So this is again down here on the range bar 6 chart. What it does out on a longer term time frame, we can look at a different time, but right now I just want to point out this short term time frame, because we took a short position right here off of this market on that red arrow, taking a short position, and we rode that down all the way from the top here down to this point here. That was about a $500 move in there on that trade. So what I want to do is I want to do a little bit of math calculation. You'll notice that I got the zigzag in here and it's tuned on, and it's pointing right here at this bar. See that low bar, that low point right there? So I want to do a little bit of a math calculation from here to this high bar. See this high bar right here? That's the peak, of course, and that's a 445% projection off this previous trend. So I want to come in, I want to do a little bit of math calculation with our Fibonacci numbers. I'm going to come off of this point here, and I'm going to go to this point here. Just that from that one run, from where that zigzag is giving us that draw. You notice that's 43 bars. So I'm going to come in with our calculator, and I'm going to go 43 times 1.618 equals, that's 69, almost 60, almost 70, 69, 70 bars. So we're going to come out to 70 bars. Where is that? 68, 69, 70. Notice that 70 bars comes right to that turning point. Pretty darn cool. What do you think of that? That's a Fibonacci projection off of that first leg to that second leg, and that's what was giving us an idea that it was going to be time to get out of the market. Of course, we trailed the blue light system and we took it out at this point here, but that was our nice little turning point. And generally you'll see that happen or occur right around where those blue lights cross over. And so if you want to do those mathematical calculations and do those Fibonacci projections yourself, feel free. It's a nice little trick, a little math trick that you can do with Fibonacci. Hi, my name is Lan Turner, and I'm the founder of Trade Mentors. If you enjoyed this video and would like to learn more about how you too can use the track and trade autopilot, the bulls and bears, the red light, green light system, as well as the blue light system, as I've exampled here, stop by my website at www.tradementors.com and see for yourself how you can start trading these fascinating markets the track and trade way.